I was pumped up because we're so fortunate to be joined by KC here. And for a lot of the fans, they haven't had the opportunity to really have extended opportunities to really hear her speak and to hear you speak. And we want to kind of pick your brain.
Yeah, we do.
Tone, you know what I mean? So I'm going to be an assistant host.
Do it.
Are we down with that?
I'm lame. Sorry, don't leave me hanging.
We need you in the game here.
Go ahead, sorry.
But no, maybe you could bring the fans inside. And for a lot of the NHL fans and the international hockey fans in general, maybe take us inside because we had you on set prior to your amazing display at All-Star Weekend. But talk a little bit about your skates. We were talking about this off air. Talk about that a little bit.
Yeah, so when I went into the All-Star Skills weekend, I was going to demonstrate the accuracy shooting competition. So I wasn't necessarily prepared from a skating standpoint. I brought one stick. I had my skate sharpened at the local pro shop at my hometown in Orland Park, Illinois. My blades weren't necessarily the thickest. They were pretty old, actually from the Olympics. So I had some new blades on the way, which didn't come in time for that moment. That's okay. So going into the moment, I was a little unprepared from an equipment standpoint.
Sure.
But that's okay. And, you know, when the moment calls, you have to perform.
And you definitely did
that. It didn't look like she was not prepared.
Right?
How about that? And there is a nature of the performer, the athlete, that the moment is now, I've got to go. There was no time for you to adjust. You just had to go with it. What about the mental part of that? There's the actual, you know, skate itself, but mentally, how did you get past it?
I would definitely say the physical part was way easier than the mental part in that moment, because the weight I felt on my shoulders as a woman in that situation, I knew there was no messing up, there was no falling, there was no stumbling, there was no do-over. It was, you have to have a clean skate, prove to the world that women belong and that we can skate just like the men.
Holy smokes. Goosebumps.
So,
does anyone else have did it get cold in here?
No, it didn't, but we wanted to.
Look at her. Flying.
She's absolutely flying. But here's the thing. KC, tell us, like, your visualization, you just talked through it when you were saying that you know you had to skate cleanly. Did you do any imagery? I know that imagery is so important to athletes.
It had to be blurry. She's going that fast.
Exactly.
Come on.
Tell us, did you do any type of imagery at all?
To be honest, yeah. I did, and I was fortunate to have a skate the day before.
Nice.
So I knew, I was hoping I was going to go the same way, and
sure,
I knew how the turns worked. But at the end of the day, I knew I had to be perfect in that skate and in that moment.
So, Tone, I got to get this one.
Please.
Here's what's interesting, right? So I remember when I first was drafted, I came in the league, and even training camp, but when I came into the league as a young player, all the posters that I had, all the hockey cards, sticker books and everything, all these players were playing on the ice. So that was a huge thing for me at the time. Oh, my gosh, that's Mario. Wow, that's Gretz.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, Steve Yzerman. Okay, yeah, we're playing them tonight. Whoa. But for you, you just looked so assured and so confident.
True.
Did you have any, because to us it appeared as though you didn't, did you have any moments of, okay, McDavid, Sid, I see you all here, all the different players, or are you just like, yeah, man, I'm just here to do my thing? Because that's the way it looked to us.
I was a little nervous. You're giving me a little too much credit here. I was nervous, but in my head, I was telling myself, you've been skating since you were 3 years old.
Nice.
It's like riding a bike. Take a deep breath. Enjoy the moment. I was so honored to be in that moment because, like we talked about, it could have been any woman. There are so many amazing players out there that led to that moment. The product we've put on the ice over the last 15, 20 years led to the conversation that we can have a woman compete in the NHL All-Star Skills competition. So I was just so honored to be in that moment and wanted to cherish it. And I couldn't wipe a smile off my face, and I still can't.
Good.
That's
Nor
awesome.
Should you. Nor should you.
And you touched on the level of competition in the women's game, and we showcase it here on NHL Network because it's great television. Anytime these two countries get together in any competition or even in just a challenge series, it's so intense. What's it like gearing up for that mentally?
Oh, mentally, you know exactly what you're getting into. We're so familiar with each other on and off the ice, whether it's, you know, the line combinations, you know their strengths, their weaknesses. So mentally, it's focusing on your team, focusing on our strengths, not focusing on them, because if we focus on them, we lose track of our game plan. So we're constantly preparing the way we need to prepare, looking at the scouting report that we've seen 100 times, and you know what? It comes down to execution, and whoever executes better, it's usually a one-goal game, overtime game,
true,
maybe a shootout, but it comes down to execution.
I remember we had some of your teammates on prior to the Olympics at NHL All-Star Weekend in Tampa, Tone, if you recall.
Oh, yes.
And they were talking about the training camp and that extended training camp that you had in Tampa. But as you prepare, maybe for a lot of the young players that are watching, and even for some of the weekend warriors, as you go through a training camp, I know from my experience, but more importantly, more importantly, rather, we want to hear from you what the training camps are like. What's the day-to-day like in a training camp as your team continues to prepare to play in these international competitions?
Definitely. The training camps are busy. You wake up, have breakfast, usually you have your first skate of the day, whether it's one to two hours long, hit the weight room for a quick lift, depending on how early on in the training camp it is. Sometimes we have fitness testing, and then usually we get back, maybe have a video session or film session of the other team or our team, and then hit the ice for another session. And then usually you're getting to bed and doing the same thing over again. And that's usually about 5 days long.
Awesome.
And the payoff is unbelievable
when
you win
exactly.
at the Olympics for the first time in 20 years.
Amazing.